Switching gears, OCFA's training and safety section recently held a tactical building construction class taught by fire captains Dan Dufresne and Paul Carlton. Attendees participated in a brief lecture before heading to downtown Santa Ana for a building walk. Topics covered included estimating area of construction, size up and initial tactics, truck placement, tactical priorities, offensive versus defensive trigger points, ICS org chart, and resources needed. Captain Carlton discussed a fire he had responded to off 4th and Broadway and asked the attendees for a size up and initial tactics. For the virtual experience of attending the class, take a moment and pause the video when prompted to answer the scenario questions with your crew.
Well, anybody want to do a size up? Let's say doors open just like this. You pull up out front to a report of a possible structure fire in 218 West 4th, and that you just have some light white smoke. What do you guys think for era of construction on this? In the middle of this whole area where we've got a lot of pre-33 and World War II era post-war construction. So the obvious in our face is how inset the windows are, the tie plates, and then we can still use neighborhood, right? We're in the community. This is what a lot of the community is. So those three things together give us a pretty good indicator. Fires in the basement, and your indicator of that is we had some smoke, light smoke kind of throughout the building, and then we open the basement door, and we get, I wouldn't say voluminous or under pressure, but we got more voluminous smoke. Access to the basement is straight through, and the door is on the left towards the back. And the basement, I'll even tell you up front, the basement for this occupancy is only under 218. It's separated. So some of these basements run like a large footprint, like the whole block, and some of them are separated by occupancy. This particular one is separated by occupancy. We've already decided we're going to upgrade to a working. So how are we going to lay out our units? What are the pros and cons of that strip mall approach of the Alpha, Bravo, Charlie, Delta designation versus Division 1, Division 2 approach on this particular building? So this particular one, we ended up stretching a hose line down. The fire was held in check. and it was a really quick knockdown. It got moved to a working. Everybody got an assignment, but that was where it stopped. And the second truck was basically made the RIC team. How do you ventilate a basement that has only one door in and no windows? So remember though what I said up front. There was light smoke in the occupancy, in the first floor area of the occupancy, right? So that smoke had to get out of there somehow, right? So one of the best ways to attack a working basement fire is through a transitional attack. So you either find a window, in this case there isn't, and you use that window as your portal to get your reset and get your initial knockdown hopefully on it. Or if you had a heavy volume of fire, you would use that doorway. But that smoke came out of there somehow. So we had a knockdown on it. We just had to remove the smoke. So this was more of a smoke removal. This wasn't a positive pressure attack. So at that point, because we're not worried about extension, we're not worried about spreading it, we just pressurized the basement and it found its way out. We're just clearing white smoke at that point. It found the holes that it was circulating up through into the rest of the building. It went positive pressure, negative pressure on the doorway. So where the fan was, it was blowing in, and then it had to come out somehow. So it came out on the top of that one opening. So, again, it's not an attack situation, it's just a exhaust type situation, but initially that threw a lot of people for a loop. We're like, how are we gonna do this?
You just wanna be sure that you have it out.
Exactly.
And yep. All the walls and all the little yep. spaces.
Right, and so downstairs you're dealing with masonry, right, in the basement, so you're not gonna have a lot of hidden fire in that type of scenario.